to focus exclusively on skeletal muscle. Skeletal muscles are organs. Each one is an organ. So the masseter is an organ. The buccinator is an organ. The gluteus maximus is an organ. And it's because of the organization that we are able to identify each of the muscles and then look in cross-section at muscle to understand the anatomy and then the microanatomy. So when we look at a muscle, the entire muscle in cross-section, we can see that it is organized into smaller units called fascicles. So an entire muscle is made up of bundles of fascicles. However, if we look more closely at a fascicle, we see that each fascicle is made up of bundles of even smaller units called muscle cells. Now remember, when we described skeletal muscle tissue, we said that the cells are long and cylindrical and multinucleated. Well, this is what we're talking about. These are the muscle cells. They are long and cylindrical and multinucleated. And so many muscle cells are bound together into a unit called a fascicle. And then many fascicles are bound together to create the entire muscle. Now, that organization is accomplished because of these connective tissues. They are from outer to inner, epimysium, perimysium, and endomysium. So an entire muscle is surrounded by a dense connective tissue sheath called the epimysium. Epi means outer or above, and it's going to surround the entire muscle. This is the reason we can discern between muscles. The teres major and the teres minor, they are very close to one another, but they are individually wrapped in this epimysium. Now, those fascicles are surrounded by perimysium. Peri means around. And so many, many fascicles bound together by perimysium create the entire muscle. And then if we work our way inside that muscle further, we see that each muscle cell is surrounded by a thin areolar connective tissue called endomysium. Endo means inner. And so many muscle cells bound together by endomysium create a fascicle. And then many fascicles bound together by perimysium create the entire muscle, which is surrounded by epimysium.